What's up, everybody? Today, I want to share with you an underrated protocol called Nexus. It will be launching in October. Their goal is to help you supercharge your yield farming on Terra, leveraging on the Anchor and Mirror protocol. In fact, Columbus 5 is going to come in 2 days' time. Please make sure that during the upgrade period, do not use any of the Terra protocol to avoid any transaction issues. Now, after Columbus 5, there are at least 30 projects that is going to come. I will be doing a review on them as well. This is what we will be going through today. So what is Nexus? They are highlighted in the Terra Spotlight project. I think what they are doing is quite cool. Most importantly, they are helping investors to cut out the risk. There are many big words over here, but I just want to say when you invest in Nexus, you are investing in bots. And they are leveraging on Anchor and Mirror protocol to get the yield. Now let us also see their mission to remove the complexity of advanced yield farming strategy. Basically, they want to make yield farming easy. And this is a big task because I try to share with friends about yield farming, but they always find it very complicated. Because we are moving funds around wallet. So what problem are they solving? They are solving three problems, so let us go through. So number one, on Anchor, reducing the risk of principal liquidation for B Luna and B ETH. Now in this example, I borrow $600 using the collateral with B Luna. Now you can see there's a $21 here. Now this is the liquidation value. If B Luna dropped to 21, then I'll be liquidated. Now this very troublesome because every day I have to come in, make sure that Luna price do not drop to 21. Also, when Luna goes up, I can borrow more. So this is a day task coming in to decide whether want to borrow more or even repay. So Nexus will try to solve this with a bot. They will front run the Anchor price bot. Instead of doing it every 30 seconds, they will do it 15 seconds. This way, before the web front end is updated, Nexus protocol bot is able to determine to repay for you or should they be borrowing more. Next, we'll take a look at the capital flow. When you put B Luna into the Nexus bot, you'll be getting back N Luna. This N Luna is in exchange for their token called PSI, and you'll be getting your yield back in PSI. And when you put B Luna into the Nexus B Luna vault, they will take the B Luna and put into Anchor Borrow. In return, they will get ANC rewards and Borrow UST. And with the Borrow UST, they will put into Anchor Earn, and in return, they will get AUST. Now, these two sources of yield will act as the revenue. In this setup, you do not need to worry if you need to repay or borrow more to maximize your yield because the bot will do it for you. Another problem they are trying to solve is one click to stake ETH chief higher staking rewards compared to the alternative staking option. For example, when I stake my ETH in Lido Finance, I get only 5%. Again, Anchor Borrow, you can put in bonded ETH, but to get bonded ETH, you go to Lido Finance and do staking. After you stake, you will get ST ETH. You have to come to anchor.lido and change it to Terra B ETH. And after you take this Terra B ETH, you have to go back to Anchor protocol to do a provide. So Nexus will introduce a new vault called EthNexus. So as a user, you will deposit ETH, and behind the scene, they will do everything else with a bot. Now I think this is very attractive because I can skip all the steps and I can claim native ETH as a yield. The problem they are trying to solve is to automate the delta neutral strategy on Mirror to beat the Anchor saving yield at 19.44%. Now let us take a look at delta neutral strategy. And on this Mirror tracker site, you are able to see the strategies on Mirror Finance. You can do long farm, short buy neutral, or short long buy neutral. Now these two are the delta neutral strategy. So for example, Netflix, you can short it and you will get 42.94% in yield with Mirror tokens, and you will get back UST. After you get back your UST, you will use it to buy Netflix so that you have a delta neutral strategy. You are not concerned about whether the price goes up or now. The goal on Nexus is to beat and achieve more than 19% in APY for the user. So as the user, you just need to deposit into the UST Mirror Vault, and behind the scene, they will execute the delta neutral strategy like I said earlier on so that they can beat the 19%, and in turn, you will get back UST. Now with their three products, let us take a look at the Tokenomics. So the total supply for PSI tokens will be 10 billion. Now this is the breakdown in details. So initially the market cap will be about 5.25 million. Now they will be launching on Pylon platform. Now this is Pylon, and this is where Terra projects can come here to launch their tokens. Very importantly, we need to make sure that they are audited, right? So all the bots so powerful, also no use if they are not audited. So they clear their audit and their reports are in their GitHub repo. Now who is this for? I think first you need to believe in the Terra ecosystem. Next, you like to automate your yield farming strategy, and you believe that as more people come onto DeFi, they will want to seek an easy way to earn high yield, and Nexus will be the one for them. So the public sale date is on the 5th October, and the token generation date is on the 11th October. Now this is the product roadmap. So the first to come is the B Luna and B ETH vault. So EthNexus will of course drawing a lot of Ethereum native users. Then the very exciting UST vault will only come next year. If you are interested, you will need to do your KYC. The KYC timing ends on 30th September. member. Unfortunately, there is a list of restricted countries that cannot take part in this. And now getting to the whitelist does not mean that you will get the tokens. It just means that it gives you a chance. Also, all the links and materials that I use here will be down in the comments below. I hope you learned something today, and thanks for watching. Bye bye.